Okay, this is the Consew 99 Zig Zag industrial sewing machine. This machine has 5/16 clearance underneath the foot. We'll sew light to medium heavyweight material. Here I'm stacking up 4 layers of upholstery grade leather. It would probably do more, but you know, 4 layers is quite a bit. This is no saddle sewer or anything by any stretch of the imagination. And it's not really a leather machine, but as you can see, it sews these 4 layers of upholstery leather easily. Now the first stitch I've done here, that's a straight stitch. It's a zigzag machine, but it can do straight stitch, and it does it well. Now I've set the machine to a medium zigzag width. This machine is capable of doing up to 5 millimeters width of zigzag. So the tension's set well on this machine. As you can see, both sides of the zigzag are even. Now I've adjusted this machine out to its widest setting, the 5 millimeter width. I haven't actually measured that, but the dial says 5. And you can see it's a pretty wide stitch. And that's of a medium length. I'll do some more sewing later in the video. Now I'll show you how to load the bobbin. Note the direction that the thread comes off the bobbin, that's important, and then you get it clipped under. Now you run it through this guide. This is from underneath the machine. Once you get your case oriented, just slip it in there and it snaps right in. Now I'll show you how to thread this machine. There's 2 holes. Go through the top one and then back around and go through the bottom one from the same direction you went through the top. From there you'll come to this device, and much like the last, you'll go in from 2 different holes from the same side. Through the guide and then into the tensioner, and then catch on the take-up spring around this guide. Note the take-up spring in operation there. Forward from there down through the guides, and then you'll thread the needle from front to back on this machine. If you ever need to know which way to thread the needle on a machine, you go through the needle towards the bobbin case. Of course, you can't see that here, but if you have access to a machine, you'll be able to see it. And here I am pulling up the bobbin thread, getting this machine ready to sew. I'll straighten out that thread that got caught down below where it should have been, and that's what it should look like. Here I just kind of show you inside the machine. It's been cleaned and oiled. Notice the grease on the gear there. That's fresh. This machine is very clean. It's well maintained. It has very little use on it. It operates very well. Now put the screws back in. So I'll do some more sewing with this machine. This is a sunbrella material. That's 2-4 layers of sunbrella. And I'll run through several of the stitches to show the machine's various capabilities. Start off with the reverse stitch. You can see that it's reverse does work. I've got two colors of thread loaded in this machine, red in the bobbin and white on the top. That helps to you easily see if the tensions are set correctly. So all white on top, all red on bottom. When the tension is out of balance, you'll see the top thread pulling around to the bottom or vice versa. And since the threads are different colors, you'll easily see that there's either some white on the bottom or some red on the top. I've timed this machine. If you ever want to check a zigzag to see if it's well timed, set it like this to its widest setting. It is at that setting that a machine is at its greatest disadvantage. So here you can see that it does its widest zigzag very well. No skipped stitches. Now I've set the machine back to a straight stitch at maximum length. I don't have the paperwork on this machine. I think it's capable of 2,000 to 2,500 stitches per minute. I'm not 100% positive about that. And this is the shortest length stitch. Have a good day.